Welcome all of you to Washington, D.C., capital of freedom in the world. And perhaps next year we can meet in Tehran. which will soon be another capital of freedom in the world. You have all sacrificed so much to restore the blessings of liberty to the people of Iran. God bless you all. And I am quite certain that the hour is fast approaching for the liberation of this great civilization. As you know, it's one of the oldest and greatest civilizations in history. And yet, for more than 40 years now, it has been brutally suppressed and plundered by a clique of theocratic thugs. In past eras, the Iranian people have known the happiness and prosperity that freedom makes possible, and they're rightly seeking to reclaim it as their birthright, and they're not alone. That's why more than 250 members of the United States House of Representatives, a solid majority of the entire House, made up of Democrats and Republicans, have co-sponsored House Resolution 118, which expresses support for the Iranian people's desire for a democratic, secular, and non-nuclear republic of Iran, and condemning the violations of human rights and state-sponsored terrorism by the Iranian regime. This is a strong statement that the people of the United States and their government want Iran's corrupt regime held accountable for its crimes against the people of Iran and their sponsorship of terrorism around the world. During a recent visit to the Iranian resistance headquarters in Albania, former Secretary of State Michael Pompeo declared, quote, "A serious missing factor in United States policy towards Iran has been the lack of political support for the organized opposition," end quote. We've got to assure that the prevailing policy of the United States is to coordinate with the Iranian resistance to return Iran to the company of free and prosperous nations. By co-sponsoring this resolution, a bipartisan majority of the House has declared its judgment that the regime in Tehran is illegitimate and dangerous to the cause of peace and freedom. Our trust is placed not in the Ayatollahs, but rather in the Iranian people. My fellow colleagues and I believe that the people of Iran are engaged in a just and righteous cause, and we are proud to stand with them. The Ayatollahs know that their days are numbered and that they cannot much longer oppress the Iranian people. We've seen the Iranian people taking to the streets year after year demanding liberty and justice. The ruling regime has denied the people these rights, and by so doing, it has lost any claim to legitimacy. The world sees that, just as you see that, and believe me, they see it too. The dictators in Iran are not content with just persecuting dissidents at home. They've committed crimes against humanity, supported terrorists across the globe, and even used their diplomats to plant bombs. 4 years ago this month, a terrorist diplomat was dispatched by Iranian rulers to blow up the 2018 Free Iran World Summit. I know many of you were present at that gathering to support the Iranian resistance movement. This terror plot was thankfully foiled, and the Ayatollah's henchman was arrested and convicted in Belgium. The bipartisan members of Congress who sponsored H-Res 118 unequivocally condemn, quote, "past and present Iranian state-sponsored terrorist attacks against United States citizens and officials, as well as Iranian dissidents, including the Iranian regime's terror plot against the Free Iran 2018, the alternative gathering in Paris. We also call on relevant United States government agencies to work with European allies, including those in the Balkans, where Iran has expanded its presence, to hold Iran accountable for breaching diplomatic privileges, and to call on nations to prevent the malign activities of the Iran regime's diplomatic missions. H-Res 118 marks the overwhelming congressional sentiment that Iranian rulers must be held accountable for their reprehensible behavior. It is well past time for the Biden administration to take into consideration Secretary Pompeo's recommendation and provide political and material support for the Iranian opposition movements and their vision of a free, secular, and democratic republic in Iran. our national security, the peace and stability of the entire region, and above all, the Iranian people's right to freedom and democracy, demand that Congress stand behind the opposition and that this administration speak out and act in their support. Ladies and gentlemen, the world stands with you and your fight for freedom. The hour has come, and all men and women of goodwill and all just nations throughout the world need now to take a meaningful stand in your great cause. Thank you.